Why don't cell phones work in airplanes? The short answer is that when you're 35,000 feet in the air going 500 miles per hour, you're just too far from a cell tower. But that got us thinking, how does Wi-Fi work in an airplane? Hey there, this is Amy for DNews, and the question, why don't phones work in planes while they're in the sky, came to us through Twitter. Some of you know that they can work if you're on a plane with Wi-Fi. From the passenger's perspective, in-flight Wi-Fi is as simple as turning on your computer and connecting to the network. But there's a lot more going on than we see. There are a couple of ways to connect to the internet on a plane. One is by a ground-based system, sort of like a cellular network. Stations set up around the country provide overflying planes with contact points. An antenna on the plane's underside transmits and receives signals to and from these ground-based towers, bringing Wi-Fi into the plane. But of course, this doesn't work when you're flying overseas or out of range of the ground network. The alternative is a satellite-based system that uses an antenna on the top of the plane that talks to satellites in orbit, sometimes in conjunction with that antenna on the bottom of the plane that talks to the ground-based towers. In both cases, the Wi-Fi signal you request from your seat gets up to the plane. But that's only half the battle, since the information has to get to you in your seat. And here's where things get a little more complicated. The seats, luggage, and even the passengers in their seats can disrupt the electromagnetic environment in an airplane and affect the way a wireless signal moves. And if people are up out of their seats moving around, and that drink cart is being pushed down the aisle, well, that just disrupts the environment more. This translates to a spotty internet connection, one that not only varies from seat to seat, it can even vary depending on where your laptop is placed on that tray table in front of you. Manufacturers are working on the problem. In 2012, Boeing filled an airplane seats with potatoes — spuds apparently mimic the electromagnetic disturbance of human flesh — to try to understand how wireless signals bounce around to bring stronger and more reliable Wi-Fi signals to future flights. And providers are doing their part, too, beefing up ground networks and developing new systems that can transmit more data. Do you guys use in-flight Wi-Fi, or do you like having an excuse to go offline when you fly? Let us know in the comments, and for more DNews every day of the week, don't forget to subscribe.